Hello and welcome back to this tutorial series for GeoGebra for using mathematics explorations. In this tutorial, we will be looking at the use of text box and an input bar with an example of a triangle construction. So what is a text box? The text box is an object that you can use to describe the construction that you have made in GeoGebra. It can reference the objects in the constructions. It can be used for showing static values, or it can be used also for showing calculated dynamic values. For calculating the values, you need to use what is called an input bar. In addition to making calculations, the input bar can also be used for defining functions in GeoGebra, which can then be displayed on the graphics view. I'm going to pause here for a minute while I pull up a GeoGebra window. You will see here there is a triangle, there is a line here. The angles have been defined, formatted, colored beautifully, but you also see that there is some text here. So now we are going to learn how to create something like this. How do we create a text box? So we will go here to a triangle that's already been drawn. So we will define the angle. We know how to do that. We have already seen it in the previous tutorial, so I'm going to do it rather quickly here. I'm defining angle BAC and I'm defining angle ACB, right? So now, and I'll also make it look bigger, and I'll make it appear outside, and I also want it to be colored differently. So let's go here and then let's give it a different color and give this angle a different color and give this angle a different color as well. Now, if you would like to define the triangle, you can do that too. We can show that, we can come up to that later, but we will not be looking at coloring the triangle right now. So now we will define a text box. A text box is this symbol you see here. It says ABC. This drop down gives you the text box. You choose the first one, which says the ABC text. Click anywhere on the graphics view and you can see here sum of angles in a triangle equal to 180. Now I want to type the symbol degree, right? So here you can see that there is an option here called symbols. So the different mathematical symbols that you will need are displayed here. Of particular interest are this basic panel, which has all the Greek letters here for you to define the angle values or anything else that you would like to define. The arithmetic operation symbols are here. The exponents are here. There are many other things as well, but I will restrict myself to showing you these three panels, which are the most commonly used. So we will choose here the thing called degree. So you have sum of angles in a triangle equal to 180 degree. Now it will be nice if we are also able to say sum of angles in a triangle is equal to angle A 77 degree, angle C 56 degree, angle B 47 degree plus equal to 180 degree. So how do we do that? So we define a text box here, but before we do that, we need to have a name by which these angles have to be referenced in the text box. So to define anything in a text box, it must be referenced with a name in the graphics view. Now we know how to do that. We select this here. We go here and say name and value. Sorry, I have given the name and value of the object. So you select the angle and say name and value. Select the angle and say name and value. And select the angle and say name and value. As you notice, you can do it from either the right click or from the panel above. So I have done both here. So now we will define another text box. Sum of angles in, you want to say triangle ABC, isn't it? So we go and look for the symbol triangle here, ABC equal to, we want to say alpha plus beta plus gamma. Now, you cannot define the alpha plus beta plus gamma from here, because here they are simply symbols. they are not referenced in this construction. If you want to reference the objects that you have made in the construction, you must go to this objects drop down box, and here you will see all the objects that have been used in the construction, the vertices, the segments A, B, C, the text that we have just defined above, which is the text 1, which is sum of angles and equal to 180 degrees, and then the alpha plus beta plus gamma, which are the angles. So now you say alpha plus beta plus gamma. Notice that when I typed the alpha plus beta plus gamma, the actual values appeared here, right? For instance, but if you had simply written alpha from the base symbol box, you will only get the value alpha. So I hope this distinction is clear. And now you can say this is equal to 180, and then go back and insert the symbol degree. So you have sum of angles in triangle ABC equal to 47 plus 77 plus 56 equal to 180 degree. Right? Now, let us say we also want it to dynamically calculate. We don't want to enter the value as 180. You want to just dynamically calculate. Right? So in this example, it does not make that much of a difference, but there will be examples where you want to define the sum of the angles using a formula, or you want to sort of derive it from this construction that you have made based on certain parameters, let us say the sum of angles in a n-sided polygon. So how do we do that? For that, we need to define the sum of the angles as another value. So for that, we use what is here called the input bar. You can see this here, the bottom rectangle here. Here you can define calculations. You can assign values to variables that you define and calculate. So before I start doing that, let me view the algebra view. So you get an idea of what we have constructed so far. We have constructed a triangle with points A, B, and C with segments A equal to 7. I will show the label here so you can see it clearly. So A equal to 7, B equal to 8, and C equal to 6. These are the three segments that constitute the triangle. We have defined one text box and we have defined another text box. Now let us say we have to define a variable here called sum of angles. And we have to again do alpha plus beta plus gamma. So how do we do that? You go here and you can define it from here because it is already there. It's easier. But let us say if you have given this name of the angle as angle A, you can also call it angle A. You don't need to necessarily give it only the name alpha plus beta plus gamma. So now you see that it defines it as a sum, which is sum of angles is 180 degree. So now what do we do here? We go back to this text box, double click it. It opens it up for editing. Delete here, go back to the objects, and enter sum of angles. So you get 180 degree. So this is how you can use a text box. You can use an input bar to dynamically change values in a text box. Now see what happens here. So the values of each one of these angles is changing, and the 180 keeps on getting calculated, right? Now before I conclude this tutorial, I also want to show you the power of using an input bar for defining functions itself. So we will open another GeoGebra file. So I'll save this as text box introduction.ggb. And we have got a new file in which we can explore the use of an input bar. Now we have the algebra view here. We have the graphics view here. Now let us say we want to plot a point. Right, so let's say we want to plot a point. We plot a point here, we plot another point B. Now let's say we want to draw a segment. So now you can see, you can either draw a segment from here like this is the way we have been used to drawing a segment, but I will undo this now and I will see how we can use a segment defined from the input bar. You see here, it gives you an option, segment, point and point, or it can say segment, point and length. So let us say I define a segment point A, segment A comma B. So the segment is drawn. It's the same thing whether I draw it using the toolbar here or I define it using the input bar below, right? So now let us say I want to define a perpendicular to this segment, right? I want to draw a point from somewhere. Let's say I plot a point A C here and I want to define a perpendicular to the segment AB from the point C. So look at the command here, perpendicular line, point comma segment. So the point is C and the segment is A, right? So you get a perpendicular line. Now let us say you want to define an angle. See the values here, angle, you can do a line or a line and a line, or you can do a point, apex and a point. So let us say I want to define the angle at this intersection. So for that I mark the intersection point, and now I go here and I define an angle which is the point, the apex and the point. So what I need to do, angle B, just need to see very clearly what this object is, B, E and C. So you see that it's defined the angle as 90 degrees. Now you would have seen by now that all the constructions that you can make using the toolbar above can be done using the input bar below, as long as you know the mathematics of how to define that function. Of course, you can't define the angle, you cannot measure the angle or the distance, etc., using the input bar. They have to be done using this panel. You can even draw a slider and text box, etc., are done from the top toolbar only. So that concludes this video, and this is an extraordinarily powerful feature of GeoGebra that allows you to use it in a very versatile manner. So I hope you will explore these options. We will see you again in the next tutorial on the creation of sliders. Have fun exploring GeoGebra until then.